हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। इफ़ यू हैव एनी क्वेरी देन कमेंट इन कमेंट बॉक्स एंड प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब माय यूट्यूब चैनल एंड लाइक द वीडियो एंड प्लीज़ वॉच वीडियो इन पीसी एंड लैपटॉप। दिस इज़ एक्सेल स्किल्स फॉर बिजनेस एसेंशियल्स वीक सिक्स कोर्स वन फाइनल असेसमेंट। दिस इज़ द वीक सिक्स कोर्स वन फाइनल असेसमेंट एंड प्लीज़ यूज़ ईयरफोन एंड माइक्रोफोन फॉर क्लियर वॉइस। This is the question number one. The heading in cell A1 cannot be seen properly. Change the alignment so that you can see what it say. In which year was this data collected? Enter your answer in four digits. Go to your Excel sheets. In Excel sheet 2015, this is the A1, this is 2015 household expenditure report. This is the first question answer. Go to the question number second. And the question number second, in somehow the data in cell B2 has lost its formatting. Change the format to a date. What date it is now shown in B2? Enter your answer in yearly, month, day format. Go to the Excel sheet. In Excel sheet you can see this is a B2 and this is the answer of 3/20/2016. If you want this assignment in the form of PDF, then comment in comment box. I will send you the report. Go to the question number third. And this is the question number third. Apply the style accent to the range A2 to Z2. Apply the style headings 3 to the range A4 to Z4. Which of the following looks most like your data? And the answer is this answer, because this answer is a heading in blue and one horizontal line, blue horizontal line, sorry. Go to your Excel sheets. In the Excel sheets have, this is a blue horizontal line, blue header and one blue horizontal line. This is a blue small little horizontal line, you can see this. And this is the answer of question number third. Go to the question number fourth. And the question number fourth is, there are also some correction you need to make the data. One of the data is entries is missing. You have been asked to insert a row after case ID 49, row 15, and enter the following data. Case ID 49, row 15. What is the total apparel expenditure now? Cell R2. Go to your, in your answer you should use the number, use a period, decimal point and two decimal number. This is a two decimal point. Go to your Excel sheet. This question answer is 4534401.10. Go to the question number 5. An incorrect value has been entered, case ID 5299. Use the find tools, find the case ID and change the January income to $200. What is the total January income now? Go to the Excel sheet. This is the case ID. Go to the control F. Go to the control F and find the case ID 5299. This is the case ID 5299 and enter this row 15. You enter in this row 200 and you find your answer. And the question number 5th answer is 607.4344.646, sorry. Go to the question number 6th. In the question number 6th, have insert a column after column H in I4, type the heading household in I5, enter a calculation to add the number of adults in G5 to the number of children in H5. Copy the formula down to fill the column in cell I2. Enter a calculation. Basically, what is this question? Have answer is 6378. How What is the total household value in cell I2? Go to your Excel sheet. And this is the I2. This is the I2 total. This is 6370. In question have put add the adults R5 adults add children add and household add. 3 plus 1 plus 4 is 3 plus 1 plus 4 is equal to 8 and 6370 plus 8. This is the answer of this question. And some question Coursera asking to you adults children, this is 3513 children, 32857 household, 6370, and sometimes he said ki add adult children household, three of them add and put in I2 and all are add. 6370 plus 8 is, this is the answer of 6378. This is the answer of question number 6. This line in I5 enter a calculation to add a number of adults add and the children add in I5. I5 is household. Both three of them is add and I2, what is the household value cell in I2? And the household value cell is before 6370, now is 6370 plus 8 is 6378. And the question number 7. In cell V5, enter a calculation to get an average income from January to June. Copy the formula down the column. What is the average income of case 20? Cell V10. In cell V5, average income. He is asking average income. Go to your Excel sheet. Where is average income? Average. This is the average income. And he is asking V10. Coursera asking V10. And this is the answer of average income of, this is the average income of 4019.36. I feel this 4019.36 V10. This is the answer of average income. And if you find this sheet, I will send to you in your Gmail ID. Please and go to the question number next. And the question number next is 8. And the question number 8 is in cell W5, enter a calculation to add up the total income from January to June. Copy the formula down the column, widen the column so that you can see the result. What is the total income for case 9 cell W6? Go to the W6 total income for case 9. Go to the Excel sheet W5. There is W5. This is the W5 and he is asking W6 answer. This is the W6 answer is 19943.28. 19943.28. This is the W6. This is the W6. This is the W6. 19943.28. This is the answer of question number 8. And go to the question number 9. In cell X5, enter a calculation to add up the total expenditure. He is asking total expenditure, case 9. Total expenditure. Copy the form in cell X5. What is the total expenditure of case 9? Go to the Excel sheet, find case 9. This is the case 9 in row 6. Total expenditure. This is the total expenditure of case 9, 10709.83. This is the answer of question number 9th. And go to the question number 10. In cell Y5, enter a calculation to subtract total expenditure from total income. कॉपी द फॉर्मूला डाउन द कॉलम व्हाट इज द नेट केस 20 गो टू द एक्सेल सीट एंड दिस इज द केस आईडी 20 एंड ही इज आस्किंग नेट गो टू द नेट दिस इज द नेट नेट इनकम ऑफ टोटल एक्सपेंडिचर माइनस टोटल इनकम दिस इज द नेट इनकम 174,23.96 दिस इज द आंसर ऑफ क्वेश्चन नंबर 10th 174,23.96 गो टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 11 एंड दिस क्वेश्चन इज माई रॉन्ग आई डोंट नो वट इज द फोरकास्ट एक्सपेंडिचर फॉर केस 9 गो टू द फोरकास्ट एक्सपेंडिचर केस 9 गो टू योर एक्सेल सीट इन एक्सेल सीट केस 9 इज दिस एंड फोरकास्ट एक्सपेंडिचर इज दिस बट आई डोंट नो हाउ माई दिस क्वेश्चन आंसर इज रॉन्ग Go to the question number 12. According to pie chart, what percentage of income is made up by net? Pie chart ke and do enter the percentage symbol in the answer box below just the number. According to the pie chart, go to your Excel sheet. In Excel sheets, this is the data and go to the status. Next. And this is a pie chart and Coursera asking what percentage income made up by net net he is asking net income is net and you find pie chart and the answer is 25 and go to the question number 13 What is the color in the cell B5? Still on the state sheets, enter a formula in B5 to add up the total income for quarter 1 using the calculated total for January, February and March. In the data worksheet, if you have done it correctly, the cell should change color. Question number 13, what color is the cell B5? Still on the status sheets and this is a purple color light purple color and the answer is purple and the question number 14 What is the total number of children recorded for the Midlands? Go to the Excel sheet. Excel sheets data. Midland. And the question number 14 is the organization has decided to have one region for the Midlands instead of two. So both East Midlands and West Midland need to be replaced with just Midlands. Go to your Excel sheet and replaced East and replace the Midlands. Basically, East in these sheets in this column have West Midlands and East Midlands, and you replace in with Midlands, then you find your answer. In your seats have West Midlands and East Midlands. You replace with Midlands. Then you find your answer in your Excel sheets. How many household in Wales have 6 or more people? Clear the previous filter, add filter so that we can only cases for Wales with 6 or more people in the household. Go to your Excel sheet. In Excel sheet, in region have Wales, and go to the data. In data, you have find filter. Go to the filter. In filter, you choose. In search option, you can type Wales. select the whales. Only whales will show this answer. And go to the household and select only 6, because Coursera asking 6 or more than 6, and the answer is 6. In this have only one row, and this is the answer of this question. And the question number 15 is 1. Go to the question number 16. What are the highest total income for a case? Clear or filter sort the data by total income in descending order. Basically, this question is very easy, and you find this answer with yourself. But my question is wrong, because this question I cleared the exam of Coursera in before 1 year. And the question number 17. What is the lowest average income for people with an intermediate occupation? And the question answer is 18.35. Go to your Excel sheet. In Excel sheets, in occupation type, go to the data and press the button filter. In filter, you select only intermediate occupation. Okay. And go to the average income. Average income is, where is average? This is the average income. And go to the filter and sort smallest to largest. And this is your answer. This is the 18.35 is the lowest income of this question. And please subscribe kar do channel. And the question number 18 is 2. And the question number 19, delete one of each of the duplicates rows. What is the new total in G2? Go to the Excel sheet. And the answer is 3513. This is the answer of question number. And Coursera asking for you, what is the children income, household total income? 6370 the household, children is 2857, and adult is 3513. G2, S2, I2. And Coursera asking, what is the new total in G2 is 3513. What is the new total in S2 is 2857. This is the 2857. What is the new total in I2? 6370. And the question number 20. My question number 20 is wrong. What is the percentage for part-time working? Go to the Excel sheet. In Excel sheet, status, part-time working. This is a part-time working. This is a part-time working, and this is the 9%. And this question answer is 9%. My answer is wrong, because do not enter percentage symbol in the answer box below, just the number. And I put a percentage. Because my answer is wrong. Please enter only 9. Not 9%. And this is the question number 21. Create a line chart showing the total income for each month. Ensure you select month names and total income values. And the answer is this. Go to the Excel sheet. In Excel sheet, and this is the answer, this graph. This is the graph of this question answer. And this graph is this. This is the answer of question number 21. And go to the question number 22. Insert a stacked column chart to show the January, February, March income for each region. Which region has the fourth highest income for January to March, fourth largest stack? Go to the Excel sheet. In Excel sheet, have fourth stack chart is this, and the fourth is this is the first one, this is the second one, and this is the third one, and fourth is this, and this question answer is London. And please subscribe my YouTube channel and like the video. Thanks for watching my YouTube channel. Subscribe kar dena.